I know what you're thinking. Sira, have you regressed and are being forced to relive every lesson you didn't pay attention to in school? And what are these clouds? Well, the clouds are mostly there for effect, and they come with lightning bolts. The monsoons are critical for most of the food we grow in the country. And half of our population works in agriculture. So if you don't know about the things that are important to half the country, do you really know India at all? So let's get to know our country a little better, shall we? Here's how the monsoon works. The earth is kind of tilted on its axis. So halfway through the year, it's really leaning towards the sun if you're in the northern hemisphere. This causes the northern hemisphere to heat up, as you might expect if you've ever leaned towards a raging ball of fire. But land heats faster than the oceans, and so does the air column above it. Hot air is less dense, so the cooler air from the sea will flow towards it. This breeze is literally dripping with water vapor it soaked up from the sea. But now that it's above land, it starts getting heated up too, and starts rising. As it goes higher, the temperature goes down, and it starts losing its ability to hold moisture. So the water vapor precipitates as rain. India gets 3/4 of its rainfall in just these months. For the mathematical amongst you, that number is more than twice what it would be if rainfall was evenly distributed. Our country moves with the ebb and flow of the monsoon winds, in tune with its rhythm, a perfect dance of nature and civilization. Sorry, but no. Depending on nature is not a mark of virtue or spirituality here. That's just a comforting thought for those of us who don't have to suffer when the monsoons are a couple of weeks late, or 5% less than usual. Almost 3 lakh farmers have taken their own lives since we started to bother counting. And the most common reason was failure of their crop. And that's only counting the people who took that final step, not the multitudes whose lives were made miserable and whose families never recovered financially. This is not being in tune with nature. It's a problem we need to solve as soon as we humanly can. So here are some solutions that people have been working on, averaging out the monsoons. The monsoon is variable. Sometimes we get more rain, sometimes less, which is kind of the whole problem. If we store this water in reservoirs and water bodies, the water could be made available for irrigation and power generation in years where rainfall is scarce. This is being achieved in India in two ways, the river linking project and lift irrigation. The Kaleshwaram Lift Irrigation Project is a gigantic megastructure, which is geared towards using a system of pipes, pumps, and barrages to get water from the river Godavari to a large reservoir. The river is at a lower level than most of the agricultural land in Telangana. But pumping the water up more than half a kilometer, this water can be made available through good old gravity, bringing irrigation to 45 lakh acres of land. How much water? 147,000 million cubic meters. This is not a mega project, it's a giga project. Is there such a thing? Well, now there is. Now, it's going to consume a lot of power to pump all of this water up almost 650 meters. And most of that power will come from burning coal, unfortunately. But you win some, you lose some, I guess. Now, some of the other possible negatives regarding this project are linked below. Using less water. During the Green Revolution, we switched to different varieties of wheat and rice, which increased production, but also required lots of water compared to indigenous varieties. This was fine and dandy as long as our water table was high. But as our population grew and water needs increased, the groundwater began getting depleted. That means that when we use bore wells now, we need to dig deeper and expend more electricity in getting this water out. Now, in order to reduce our water requirement, we can use micro-irrigation. It's exactly what it sounds like. CIPT ran a trial using this technology and found that the amount of water used fell to less than half and in some cases to a quarter. And not only did it save water, it improved productivity as well. Pretty incredible. Tensiometers are devices that help farmers figure out if the soil has enough moisture for the crops they've planted. CIPT ran an experiment in Punjab where they taught farmers how to use tensiometers and found that water and electricity usage both declined significantly. In order to convince the farmers to give up their traditional ways of figuring out how much water to use, they even arranged an insurance scheme which would pay out if using tensiometers led them to losing income. This did not happen though. Their crop yields increased. Okay, they didn't actually explicitly say that. But worst case, it would have stayed the same, right? Right? So anyway, it looks like the technology is something we might be able to use on a bigger scale. Tensiometers may not be as magical as altiometers, but they're real and they work. Then there are these treadle pumps, which can really help out small-scale farmers for whom diesel pumps are unaffordable. IDEI has won several international awards and sold over 1 million treadle pumps so far. So you can imagine how useful they've been to farmers across the country. These were some of the technological solutions through which we can begin to alleviate the effects of a fickle monsoon. But there are economic ways of bettering farmers' lives too. The Prime Minister's Fasal Bima Yojana, for example, which insures farmers against loss of income and not just investment. Online marketplaces which allow farmers to better control when and for how much they sell their produce. But on this channel, we talk mostly about tech and science. So I'll leave that to my betters. Here's one of them who talks about finance and stocks and other incomprehensible stuff. Go check her out. The smell of the first monsoon rains is one that has shaped our very evolution. It used to mean so much to so many, and it still does. In the years to come, let's pray that we can welcome it, not as a savior, but just for the cool, fresh joy that it brings in from the sea. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Like, share, subscribe, and start a conversation below to get more videos like this in your recommendations. I'll see you really soon. Bye.